Welcome to Finance Friday, and today we're going to tell you a story about a woman who is incredibly grateful about being a business owner for the first time and what it meant to get to that point. Welcome to Finance Friday, where we talk about facts and fundamentals of finance on Friday.
A lot of people kind of fall into the idea of becoming a business owner. It happens maybe because they downsize from their career and they have no other choice. Or in the case of our client, she kind of fell into it because she was an employee. And the owner of her business just said to her, "I don't want to do this anymore. Do you want to buy it from me?" And our client just never thought in a million years that she could have the opportunity to become an owner of a business.
I think the tricky part, even though she's getting through the process, was she knew the craft of the business.
That she did.
Okay, so the skill was there to be in the business.
Yeah.
But it's a different ballgame when you have to run the business and own the business.
She said to me this morning on the phone, she said, "You know, all these things keep popping up. And I didn't expect these things. And, you know, thank you for being there for me to answer the questions."
Mm-hmm.
It just shows that a lot of people who are becoming business owners maybe aren't prepared for it.
Mm-hmm.
They have the dream for it, but maybe they're not prepared for all of the
logistics.
So I said to her, "This isn't going to stop."
Right.
"In a couple of days, you're closing on your business purchase and you will be the owner of the business."
It's sort of like when you go from renting an apartment to buying a house and you want to own the house because, you know, you're building equity and you have maybe more space and it's yours. But then the water tank blows, or you have to put a new roof on, or you have to repaint the ceiling. And those aren't sexy items.
You have to climb up on a ladder and clean the gutters.
Yes. Or the chimney flashing.
There's an intangible benefit, though, of the home ownership. And that's what I said to our client. I said, what you have to do to kind of calm yourself as you become a business owner and build your business is to wake up every morning and to go to bed every night knowing one truth about yourself. You're independent.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have a boss. It's your business. You own it and you can do with it as you please. And
right.
She paused a very long time on the phone. In fact, I thought the call dropped. And she said, "That is very helpful. Thank you." I used to tell my first-time buyers the intangible benefits of owning a house help you get through those challenging moments of the hot water heater bursting or the leak into the attic because the chimney flashing is loose. That's why I love that you brought up owning a house.
Well, while you were on the phone with our client, I was on the phone with one of our insurance buddies in Michigan.
What's up, dude?
Jason. And he said, "Oh, well, you guys are business consultants, right?" I'm like, "Well, yes and no. I guess you haven't been watching our videos. Are you watching our video right now?" I told him how we're commercial financing brokers, but because of all that's required when you're doing a round of financing, there's an inherent business consulting that is going on there, which is why we're very excited that we put together a program to help business owners who may not need us to find them a lender or secure the loan for them and have that handholding process.
They just want us to look at their paperwork and set them in place so they can walk into the bank on their own. It's kind of a coach.
We run credit reports as part of the program so that we can take a look at what's going on with your credit report. Sometimes there are things on there that will affect how the financing goes, so we can help you identify those.
And we're going to look at your financial statements, your business plan, and ask you some questions and put that together and kind of come back to you, say, "Well, this is what we think you should do as you go into the bank. We also have access to our lender matrix. So if we have to shoot an email out on a hypothetical,
which I think is really key as people try to continue the relationships they have with their existing bankers. Our aim is to increase the number of loan approvals that business owners have, period.
With our help as a broker, with our help as a consultant, or with these videos we do. Either way, we want you to be more successful when you need to apply for a bank loan to get working capital to grow your business.
Honor your ambition, expand your enterprise. I'm Linda Ray.
And I'm Trevor. And we
are Aurora Consulting, financing solutions for your business success story.